we discuss Mendel's dihybrid cross. In monohybrid cross, Mendel took only one contrasting character. But whereas in dihybrid cross, Mendel took two contrasting characters. Those two contrasting characters are yellow round seeds crossed with green wrinkled seeds. Yellow round seeds and green wrinkled seeds. The alleles of yellow round seed are YYRR. The alleles of green round seeds are YYRR. So in Mendel's dihybrid cross, two contrasting characters are taken. Two contrasting characters are yellow round seeds, capital Y, capital Y, capital R, capital R. Whenever we write capitals, it is dominant. And small y, small r, green wrinkled, this is recessive. When you cross capital Y, capital R into small y, small r, that is yellow round, green wrinkled. The F1 generation will be capital Y, capital R, smaller. The F1 generation is capital Y, capital R, smaller. Because of the law of dominance, this is called yellow round. Because capital Y is there, capital R is there, it is yellow round. Now, this yellow round, capital Y, capital R, small r, is intercrossed with another F1 generation to get F2 generation. The genes are capital Y, capital R, capital Y, small y, capital R, small y, small r. These are the genes obtained from this one and this one. Now, we will draw a checkerboard to explain this combination. This is called checkerboard or Punnett square. Who discovered this? Here we make four blocks on both sides. We make four blocks on both sides and we take genes on the upper side. First is capital Y, capital R. This side also capital Y, capital R. This is female and this is male. Now, then capital Y, small r, capital Y, small r, then small y, capital R, here also small y, capital R, then small r, small y, small r. So these are the genes taken in the checkerboard on both sides. Now combinations. This combination is capital Y, capital R, yellow round. Next, capital Y, capital R, small r, again yellow round. Then, capital Y, capital R, again yellow round. Then, capital Y, capital R, small r, again yellow round. So, this is the parental F1 generation. This is the parental F1 generation or double heterozygous. This is double homozygous. That is double heterozygous. Now, capital Y, capital R, small r. This is also yellow round. Capital Y, capital R, small r. Now, capital Y, small r, small r. A new combination came, that is yellow wrinkled. Yellow wrinkled. Next, Y, capital R, small r. Again, double heterozygous, yellow round. Again, double heterozygous, yellow round. Now, Y, small r, small r. This is again yellow wrinkled. Again, yellow wrinkled K. Now, Y, capital R, capital R. It is again yellow round. Then capital Y, small y, capital R, small r. This is yellow round, that is double heterozygous. So here double heterozygous, here double heterozygous, here double heterozygous. Then small y, capital R, capital R. This is green round. A new combination came. Green round. Then small y, capital R, small r. This is also green round, a new combination. Green round, a new combination. Now, capital Y, capital R, small r. This is again yellow round. So see here, this is double heterozygous, this is double heterozygous, this is double heterozygous, this is double heterozygous. So in total, how many double heterozygous? Four double heterozygous are formed. Now capital Y, small r, this is yellow wrinkled. Next, small y, capital R, small r, this is green round. This is green round. Now small y, small r, this is green wrinkle. So these are the 16 combinations that are formed in dihybrid cross. These are the 16 combinations that are formed in dihybrid cross. So in total, how many combinations are formed? 16 combinations are formed. In these 16 combinations, if you write the ratio, which is called phenotypic ratio, which is called phenotypic ratio, it is 9:3:3:1. 9 are yellow round. That means yellow round, 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 yellow round. So in total, 9 yellow round. 3 yellow wrinkled. 3 green round. And 1 green wrinkled. That means the actual parental combination is yellow round and green wrinkled. But in between, new combinations came. How many new combinations came? 6. In 3:3 ratio, that is 1:1 ratio. These three combinations are yellow wrinkled and green round. Why these new combinations came means, during the moment of genes, instead of going together, there is an independent assortment or separation. That's why Mendel's dihybrid cross is used to prove law of independent assortment. Law of independent assortment. So in total, how many double heterozygous are formed? 1, 2, 3, 4. These are 4 double heterozygous. How many double homozygous? 1, 1. The remaining all are, this is for yellow homozygous, round heterozygous. Yellow heterozygous, round homozygous. Like this, different combinations are formed during Mendel's dihybrid cross.